33 and 34. Chittavagga. Now going to talk about the mind, chitta. To understand the nature of human mind, can follow me. Pandanam chappalam chittam. Durakkhaṁ dunnivārayaṁ ujjuṁ karoti medhāvi. Usukārov tejanam. Pandanam chappalam chittam dunnivārayam ujjuṁ karoti medhāvi usukārov tejanam vārijov thalekitto. Paripandati idam cittam. Mardeyam pahatare. Varijo sthale kitto. Okamokat ubbato. Paripandati dam cittam mardeyam pahatare. Meaning, the first one, the flickering, fickle mind, difficult to guard, difficult to control. The wise person straightens it as a fletcher straightens an arrow. The nature of the mind, pandana. Pandar means jump here and there. Cannot even 1 second mind cannot keep quiet. Must. Because mind runs so quickly, so rapidly, and it is very difficult to control. So always jump here and there. Then the 5 senses are waiting. Through these senses, the energy always runs. This mental energy, eye consciousness, ear consciousness, and all the 5 consciousness, catch an external object, just like catching birds. After catching objects, eyes, ears, nose, mouth, and the body, feeling, bring them to the mind again. Then there will be a very big battle in the mind. What to do with this object? Whether to accept or to reject? Whether to make use of it or to give up? If it is very fascinating, which creates temptation, and then mind likes to accommodate it and make use of that object. If it is very irritable, very ugly, filthy object, the mind has to reject this. So That is what mind is doing. No peace at all. Even while sleeping, when the senses are quiet, subconscious mind starts to project the thought, the concept, the idea, the habit, what we have deposited, recorded in the subconscious mind. Then appear as dreams. Dreams always appear, but we cannot remember. Some people say, very seldom they come across the dream. But people cannot remember the dreams. Some are very dangerous. Some are very peaceful. And some are very useful. Some are very, fearful. Nature of the mind. Even certain things that we have experienced during our childhood, we experience. Now I can remember, even today, here, how I spent my life as a child with my father and mother and brothers and sisters while playing and jumping here and there, appear in dreams. Even today, in another country. This is the nature of the mind. So, pandanam chapalam. Chapalam means fickle, fickle-minded. You say you are fickle-minded. That means you cannot fix your mind. Or you cannot make up your mind. Always you change your mind. It's a fickle-minded person. Promise to do something, forget. Promise not to do something, again, commit. It's called fickle mind. The mind is like that. This is the nature of the mind. Pandanam chapalam chitta durakkham. Rakkham means protect. Du means difficult. Durakkam, difficult to protect. Very, very difficult. Difficult to control. Ujum karoti medhavi. Medhavi means wise person. Understanding person. Ujum karoti, a straighten. Mind is crooked. Always crooked. But wise man knows how to straighten it. That means a straightforward. A straightening means train the mind to stand firmly, straightforward. Never change the word. Never change the mind. Never change the attitude. Ujum karoti medhavi. Usukaro tejanam, just like a fletcher, a carpenter, taking a crooked piece of wood, after cutting and sharpening here and there, make it straight, make arrow. So, by knowing the nature of mind, wise people try to sharp the mind, clean the mind, adjust the mind, train the mind, then make use of the mind. Otherwise, we cannot use the mind. Wasting. I think I have mentioned this on many occasions, how we waste our mental energy for nothing through our five senses. So every minute, every second, we are using energy, mental energy, for unnecessary things, to see certain things which are not important, to hear certain things which are not useful, and smell certain things also doesn't give us anything, and taste, become crazy to experience the taste. Then feeling, sensation, mind, experience. Senses cannot experience anything. That's why you say, eye consciousness experiences, not the eye. Ear consciousness experience, not the ears. The mental energy is working. So while wasting and wasting, what will happen? Mind become very weak. Not enough energy. We have wasted. That is why we have fear. We are not strong. Mind is not strong. Fear, worries, suspicion, and imagination. Because cannot understand. No energy to digest. Then create imagination. These are weaknesses. When the mind is strengthened, straightened, then we can get rid of unnecessary, undue fear, suspicion, worries. Because of our suspicion, we create enemies. We suspect others. But we do not know how far it is true. That is our belief. We do not know how to analyze, how to penetrate our mind to understand. So all our weaknesses we are experiencing due to weakness of the mind. If the mind is strong, even ghost or devil or evil spirit also cannot harm, cannot approach, because the mental energy can topple them. They are scared of this energy. In the Buddha's teaching it is mentioned. Now, cosmic energy is a very big word, can give so many meanings, interpretation. Let us take energy influence through the planet, sun and the moons and various other planets. These planets can affect our body, our brain, especially our brain. And then changes take place in our life through the influence of planet. It is natural, whether we believe or not, whether we can understand or not, it is natural. Now you can understand. Full moon day, through the influence of the moonlight, the water, high tide, low tide, because of the moon. Because moon influences the fluid, water. During the full moon time, 2-3 days, we can see so many lunatic cases, talking rubbish, laughing, through the influence of the moon. The brain cells and the fluid in the brain astir, and then imbalance of the mental energy. After that, started to talk rubbish and laugh and dance. Moon, sun, life exists because of the sun. Otherwise, no living being on this earth. That is why few thousand years ago, especially in China and India, before this concept of God appeared in the man's mind, they worshipped sun and the moon, especially sun. They knew sun is responsible for our living. We are living here because of sun. So there is no harm of worshipping. They are not doing anything wrong. But still people are doing it. But there is no religious value out of gratitude. We respect the sun and the moon. Then, other planet, we do not know what they are doing. Astrologers say, sun and the moon, just like food and water for our life, essential. But the other planet, just like vitamin, vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin B, and vitamin also very important for our living, to lead a healthy life. So these planets also support us. But lack of vitamin creates certain sicknesses. When these planets influence wrongly, then we experience problems, sicknesses. The Buddha did not advise us to surrender ourselves to the planet. But he accepted, he admitted, planet can influence our body, our life. But if the mind is strong, if we develop the mind, that energetic mind can topple the influence created by the planet. This is Buddha teaching. Christianity did not accept astrology for many years, a few hundred years. Later, a well-known Christian saint, St. Thomas Aquinas, he has made a beautiful statement. He says, planet can influence the elements of the body, but not the mind. He is repeating what the Buddha has said earlier. They accepted planet can influence the elements of the body, but not the mind. That means the mind is strong. The planet cannot influence. This is the worldly thing, the development of the mind. If the mind is not trained, what will happen? We won't be able to make use of our human life. Because the man or the human, the word derived from mind, or the word mind derived from mana. Man means mind. Now people don't like to use the word man anymore. Recently, I received a letter from South America. After reading one of my booklets, this person has corrected. The word man, he has changed into human, completely changed. No more man, only human. Because ladies don't like it. Why only man? But at the beginning they never had that concept. Man means mankind. But no more mankind, humankind. So, asking my idea, whether I like it or not. Because they wanted to reprint this one. I think no harm at all. Then I also change here and there in other publications. Try to reduce this word man into human or humanity. So, man means mind. One who has a mind to think is called man. Then, woman also man. Who man? Also man. Then why worry? We analyze it this way. Not woman. Who man? Next one. Varijo thale kitto oka mokata ubbato paripandati dan chittang mardeyam pavate. Like a fish that is drawn from its watery abode and thrown upon land, even so does this mind flutter. Hence should the realm of the passions be shunned. It's very funny language. Translate. To me it is like this. Instead of eating like this, he tried to eat like this. Exactly like this. The thing that you can tell straight, going round and round and round this way, after you cannot catch the idea. This is the nature of the language. Pali, Sanskrit languages, they use in this way. The meaning is not very difficult. Like a fish that is drawn from its watery abode and thrown upon land. When you catch a fish and throw out to the land, then what will happen? This fish flutter, always jump here and there. I think you can remember the story, one of the previous birth story of the Buddha. The Buddha had a severe headache. Throughout his life he had to suffer. Then he explained to his disciples, "Do you know why I am suffering from this headache? There is no cure. During one of my previous births, I saw a man was fishing. So this man, after catching the fish and throw out to the land, and this man, Bodhisattva, at that time, he was enjoying, laughing, how the fish were jumping here and there, just like small children. The small children like to see this kind of thing. So he encouraged and enjoyed this fishing and dying. Because of that, today I am suffering from this headache. Such minor mistake. So we must never encourage others when they slaughter, when they kill, when they destroy other living beings, must keep living. We must never encourage, participate in their act of killing. So, the mind is just like that fluttering or jumping fish out of water. Because fish cannot survive without water. By knowing this situation of the mind, the nature of the mind, māra dheyyaṁ pahātave, impurities, passions, evil thoughts. In simple language, evil thoughts, bad thoughts, pahātave, try to cleanse the mind from these evil thoughts. Because evil thoughts influence the mind to create mistakes, bad things, wicked things, harmful things. Cannot control the mind because of that situation. Impurities of our mind that we maintain indicate through our character, our behavior, our way of life, the way how we talk, the way how we do things. There is another saying in Sanskrit language. Although we cannot see the mind, no one can see the mind, but there are certain indications for us to understand the nature of a mind, of a person. When we watch very carefully, we can understand this person is like this. This person is cunning. This person is kind. This person is cruel. This person is learned. This person is religious minded. This person is foolish. We can understand, although we cannot see the mind. The saying is like this. Ākārai ingitai yatya cheshtaya bhāsanenacha netra vaktra vikārena lakshate antargata mana. The way how people look at things, when you watch very carefully, you can understand something, the nature of this person's character. Different people have different techniques of watching things. Ingitai, the way how this person shakes his head or hands, like this or like this. You can understand the nature of the mind. And watch how this person walks. You know, the blind man comes here every morning to massage because of these diabetic problems, muscle cramps and pricking pains, and can get rid of them and massage the leg. So when he gets used to few people here, from far distance he can say, after hearing the footstep, oh, so-and-so is coming, so-and-so is coming. Because he knows the way how this person walks, indicates. Then, watch very carefully, can understand something, the nature of this person. The other day I told you, I think Dhammika told you this story, that young lady who agreed to marry the Buddha. And when the Buddha rejected or refused, and she got angry. But her mother, old lady, having seen the footprint of this Buddha, she told, it is mentioned like this, Rattasahi Kutikang padang bhave, duttas hoti sahasanupilita, mulhas hoti avakadhitang padang, vivatachadda idamidisang padang. The shape of the feet. When we keep our feet like this, we can see
Some people's goes like the curved, this area. See, like this. Not a straight, like this. Goes like this. The feet goes like this. That means he or she is very, very romantic. Don't look at your feet now. When you go home, you can see. That is the nature of romantic life. Buddhasahoti sahasanavita. Man who is very cruel or very ungrateful. Very straight, like this. And the whole thing can be seen. The print, mark. That means his or her character is very ungrateful or very cruel. That's why I told you not to see your feet. Mulhasya hoti avakadditam pana. A foolish man, when he keeps his feet like this, mark we can see here in this part and this part, but not in the middle, nothing. Like this. Hollow there. A lizard can go through. Can you keep like this? This is the nature of the feet of a foolish man. This old lady said this. Therefore, this feet is free from all these things. The formation of the feet of the Buddha. So, ākārai ingitar gatya. That's why when a person walks, watch very carefully how he can step. Then can see this person is like this. The way how that person laughs. Different people have different ways of laughing. Some people just, that's all. Some people open the mouth, some people make hell of a noise. different ways. That indicates the nature of the character. The way how this person talks. Then, the way how this person do things. How this person handles things. You can watch very carefully. Now, if we ask somebody to go and bring this book, and some people go, another person come, see the difference now. Watch very carefully how they handle things. Different characters. When they write, you can see. Some people write very slowly, 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 like Mr. Silva. Some others, and so many spelling mistake and cannot read. Cannot read. Two wives were boasting about their husband. One wife said, "Do you know, my husband is very learned man. When he writes anything, he himself must read, another person cannot read. He's very clever." He's very learned. Then the other wife said, "I think my husband is more clever than you. When my husband writes something, he himself cannot read." Very learned. So that is the character, the nature of person. That is why many people can see the character after reading and writing. It's a well-known technique. You can send your handwriting, they'll tell you your character, your behavior, your nature, the way how you write. So, the whole body, the face, from here up to here, everything indicates the nature, character of a person. The formation of the nose, eyes, eyebrow, forehead, and the chin, and the teeth, and the lips. See, 100 people, and you can see the differences. The formations of the chin and the teeth and the lips and the forehead and eyes, different characters. Those days people learned these things. Those two countries, China, India, Greece, those three countries. But today many people do not know actually. So, by knowing the nature of this mind, we must try to make use of this mind, because only human beings have intelligence, sense of reasoning, analytical knowledge, common sense. Others have no common sense, either instinct or habit, and just to recognize, identify. They cannot go beyond that. But human beings have very sharp mind. So if we develop this, then we can avoid so many problems and troubles and disturbances. We can cultivate our way of life. We can understand things properly. And we can lead a peaceful and noble and respectable life when the mind is trained properly. And education. The main purpose of education is to train the mind. Discipline. How to behave as human beings. But today, the purpose of education is job-orientated education. Rat race. Seeking big job to draw big salary to enjoy life. That is the purpose of education. Competition. Because of racial arrogance, religious discrimination, color bar, these things are the background that can be very cruel, very immoral, very wicked, very dangerous. Doesn't matter if they can make money. That is the purpose of life. In the end, what do they gain? Nothing. They experience more worries, more frustration, more disappointment, unhappiness. But when we train ourselves through our education from childhood, we know how to face our problems. We know how to overcome our problems. We know how to avoid problems and trouble and difficulty. We know how to lead a respectable life without harming, disturbing others. But those things are not important today. That is why the whole world is like a madhouse. They are killing each other for nothing. The human mind is completely gone out of order. Another thing, I do not know how far it is true. I have read this. When people live for few generations on the top of the flat without touching the ground, their mentality, they have noticed a lot of changes in their mind. Because very seldom they touch the ground, the earth. It is very important to touch the earth, our feet, just like earth to radio and television. We must touch the ground, barefoot. We spend for a few generations, 30, 40, 50, 60 stories high. Environment is entirely different. Then changes take place in human mind. I have read this in certain magazines, according to their observation. Because we were born to live on the earth, not in the air. But according to our way of life, we have discovered new methods, new techniques, but not knowing that these things are harmful to us, not suitable for us. Now many people are going away from the town, from those flats, to countryside, like to stay hill, jungle, take fresh water, fresh vegetables, fresh air, every day, touching the ground. Now, reflectology, this one, we never knew this earlier. Countryside, people never use shoes or slippers. They climb hills and rocks. They climb the trees to pluck coconut and fruits. That is reflectology. And they are free from many of those modern sicknesses. We never knew all these things. So we are going against the nature. Animals are still very fortunate. They are living according to the nature. They are food, and they are what you call daily routine. They have a time to go to bed, especially birds. They have a time to get up. Certain birds get up very early and start singing, jumping here and there. Why do they want to get up so early? To go to office? Go to school? That is, they follow the nature. And evening, 6, 7, they go to bed. In our case, up to 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock also, we have no time to go to bed. But we do not know enormous sicknesses, troubles, problems, worries that we had to face for changing our way of life. We were not born to this world to behave like this. We are crazy for this and that. No contentment, no satisfaction. Whole day and night, without taking rest, without eating, without sleeping, work and work and work for earning to enjoy, but no time to enjoy, kick the bucket earlier. Suffer to enjoy, but nobody to enjoy. Ah, this is our way of life. When the mind is trained, then we can reduce all these unnecessary things. Not to waste our valuable time, to make use of this life, because there is a purpose, there is an aim. The other day also I mentioned, the human life is the center in between heaven and hell. This is the center. That means, human mind, when it is trained and developed properly, can experience heavenly bliss, peace and happiness and satisfaction. Humans can do this easily, but other living beings cannot do it. On the other hand, human life can create hell very easily. Because of their cunningness, crookedness, wickedness, they create more bad things, more wicked things, more harmful things than other living beings. Other living beings, they kill only for their food or because of fear. Otherwise, they never disturb other living beings. But we are destroying all living beings on this earth, in this world. That means we are creating our hell very easily. Other living beings cannot create their hell so easily. So human life is so important. It is the center to decide whether to go to heaven or hell. Of course, in other religions, they interpret in this way. God created human life and watch how these humans live. If they go against their religious principle, condemned to hell. if they follow these religious principles, sent to heaven. Shortcut. Very easy to understand. But the truth is this. We create our own heaven according to our way of life. If we abuse our human life by misusing our human intelligence, many educated people misuse their human intelligence. Foolish people are harmless people because they have no cunningness, cruelty, jealousy also you cannot find among foolish people. Only educated people, intelligent people are the dangerous people. They know all the dirty tricks, harm others, disturb others, to destroy others. Human mind. Here in this sayings of the Buddha, what he is trying to explain to us, for us to understand the nature of our mind, not to abuse our mind, although we can do that. What is the story? Why the Buddha had to say this? He is saying, now here in short form, the story is here. Only two lines. A monk was overcome by evil thoughts. The Buddha admonished, subdue his mind. A monk who got fed up with monk's way of life, knowing that there are so many precepts, so many religious rules, so many manners for him to observe. He said, I cannot observe so many precepts, too much. Therefore, I want to go home. When the Buddha came to know this, this particular monk is ready to go home because he says there are so many precepts that he cannot observe. Then the Buddha asked him to come. Is it true that you are going to disrobe and go home because you cannot observe so many precepts? Yes. It is true. Then the Buddha asked, can you observe only one precept? Forget about the rest. One precept. Then he said, can. All right. Then, try to keep quiet. Can you do that? Yes, I can do that. Keep quiet. If you keep quiet, you don't do any bad thing. Then, just keeping quiet, very silent, then started to think, and very, what you call, very soothing. Now, no worries, no disturbances, and no burdens. Then slowly develop his understanding through this method. Buddha has different techniques for different people. Just like the doctors, when they diagnose the real nature of the sickness, he give a jab, injection. Exactly like this. Buddha's teaching is like that. Giving injection, the proper dosage, by diagnosing the nature of the thing. Buddha is called Vaisajya Guru. When Mahayana schools developed, they have introduced the names of so many Buddhas. Manjushri, Vaisajya Guru, Amitabha, Padmasambhava, different names. But they are very meaningful names. Bhaisajya means medicine. Vaisajya, Pali word. Bhaisajya, Sanskrit word. Guru means teacher. Oh, master. Vaisajya Guru, today people introduce as medicine Buddha. Vaisajya Guru. The Buddha's medicine is by realizing the nature of mentality, nature of the ill will or anger or jealousy or grudge or evil thought, he gives a proper dosage to get rid of them. A proper method for this person to concentrate or to contemplate or to be mindful or to fix the mind to avoid those forces. Then they get the chance to get cured their sicknesses. In that sense, sicknesses means not physical, mostly mental. But remember, mind can create enormous sickness. Modern psychology says 75% of our sicknesses created by our mind. Mind is responsible for these sicknesses. If the mind is clear, if the mind is pure, these sicknesses never appear. When the mind is polluted, that polluted mind not only create bad deeds, polluted mind creates so many sicknesses. When the mind is polluted through anger or grudge or jealousy or ill will or selfishness, what will happen? It will become a very energetic evil force. This evil force first disturbs the brain cells, neurons. After that, gland, tender part of the organs of the body. Glands produce different kind of hormones. These hormones also become poisonous. Then these hormones mix up in the blood. In the blood also become poisonous. You know, there are some people, when they want to slaughter an animal, they don't cut at once and prepare to eat. They allow the blood to flow. They say, when we cut, kill, the hatred, anger, fear, tension that appear in that creature's mind poisons the blood. When people take this with that fresh with the blood, they get different type of sicknesses. Some people do that. Anyway, don't follow my method. You can say, I learned this from the Reverend. He asked it. So, but it's meaningful. How mind can purify, what do you call it, poison, then create sickness. Immediately we can understand. When we get a shock, very dangerous, intolerable, within few minutes, we want to go to toilet. Everybody experienced it. How that mental energy affected the stomach. And when people are in fear, terrible fear, automatically pass urine. Fear. That is mental energy. I have told you this incident. One of our members have gone to Cameron Highland for 1 week holiday. When they were in Cameron Highland, thieves entered into their house and taken away valuable jewelry and money and everything. Somebody telephoned next door, I think, neighbor. What happened? As soon as she got this news, within 5 minutes, rashes,
appear all over the body.
The shock she had
after hearing this shocking news. Few years ago, when we were having a Temple Road girls' school here, night classes, one Malay girl who was studying here was waiting there for her father to come and take her home. But the father didn't come. Nearly 9 o'clock at night. Because they are not used to the temple and not to associate with monks, and this is entirely different religion. And she sitting there thinking. And I went, I said, what are you doing here? Why don't you go home? She said, I'm waiting for my father. I telephone and no news. I don't know what to do. I say, when she was talking to me, I think she had more fear in her mind because she doesn't know me. Then slowly, slowly, she had a difficulty of breathing. Because this is an asthmatic case. And that fear aggravated asthma. It is always like that. Now he cannot breathe. Like that. Then I went inside and prepare a cup of coffee for her and asked her to drink hot coffee. Then are the telephone number found out. Father has left. Something happened to a motor car on the way. If that poor man is struggling there, he cannot come. I said, don't worry. If your father cannot come, we inform the police and hand over to send you to your home. Don't worry. The fear immediately aggravated that hidden asthma. All of us have to experience many kinds of sicknesses. If the mind is as strong, we are safe. Even devil goes out to run away if the mind is strong. If you say, I don't care who they are, then they run away. If you say, well, we care of them, then they will come and jump and catch you. Mind creates all these things. Buddhism always tries to strengthen the mind, not to create fear, strengthen the mind.